The nation's most desperate and pathetic armchair quarterback is at it again. Hillary Clinton is unnaturally fixated on the one that got away. And I'm not talking about the White House. She is so obsessed with the president. She was watching last night's El Paso rally like a gate-mouthed cow waiting to insert herself into a story no one is writing about her, and finally found her entree when the president said this.
I love this state, and I love the people of this state. We've had a great romance together, you know that. It's been a great romance. And we're only getting stronger together.
Oh, as you remember, Stronger Together was one of Clinton's failed campaign slogans. And also the title of the most uninteresting book ever written by her and Tim Kaine. It is a piece of literary ambient called Stronger Together that deserves boredom burning. The perpetual candidate and two-time loser, well, three if you count being saddled with her husband, Bill, the alleged buggerer. She tweeted this morning, quote, "Now copy my plan on health care, a fair tax system, and voting rights. No thanks. No one cheats off a loser." And apparently no one loses a cheater. Her tax plan is a pathetic garbage pail of warmed over populist leftovers. Big taxes to fund even bigger, more expensive government programs, also known as failures in waiting. Employing the Buffett rule to gouge high earners, also known as winners, to fund progressive investments. Oh, gag me with a silver spoon, you corporatist hypocrite harpy. I know she's running for president again. We all know that. And she'll once again lose the war of electoral attrition, as she won't even make it through the primaries as her party's nominee. Her rotten health care plan piggybacks on Obamacare, which is like curing rosacea with chicken pox. Government broke health care by conflating it with health insurance and expanding already strained entitlements, and throwing more government at a system ruined by too much of it is short-sighted, on the verge of being criminal. The Democrat Party is only stronger together by turning their collective back on its fast-fading star. By pretending everything is about her, does little to materialize her almost presidency. But the thought of another humiliating loss makes me want to indulge her delusion. On that, I'm with her. And that's the memo.